President, General Secretary, and Office Bearers of the NCHRO, our respected VTR, who is a fitting person who has been conferred with the award, and also the wonderful speech that has been made by Kanjileya. So far, I have read them only by the letters, editors and all. Today only, it's a chance for me to hear the wonderful speech that were made, and especially the speech made by Kalaichelvi. I feel that as if she's from Tamil Nadu and our land of Periyar. No? I really appreciate the NCHRO. It has provided a very space for the diversification of views from different angles and all. That's why NCHRO is occupying a specific, unique post in India. That it is the only organization, pioneering organization, which is now paving the way for the real humanitarian emancipation and all. I want to cut short my speech because I want to hear the speech of our special guest and others here. Of course, the only fight is now. Now, India has got 200 years of British Raj, as Comrade Ballin said. And previously, here there was a Raj of Brahminism was there. When 200 years of British Raj was there, our leaders fought for independence. Simultaneously, there was a movement for more than 2,000 years that's called the Social Liberation Movement. And you might have heard about the articles of Ambedkar with Gandhiji, Joshi and all. When one person has called that, you are all against the trade union movement, you are all against the workers, you want to form a separate union. That time Ambedkar told that, you people are fighting against the British Raj, against the colonialism for 200 years, whereas I have been fighting for 2,000 years against the social repression of my community. That's what he said. For 2,000 years, the community has been oppressed, suppressed, segregated from the society, and has been caused up all injustice. Now, we have got our own constitution that says that all are equal before law, equality, equal protection of law, no discrimination on the basis of caste, creed, sex, religion, no discrimination on the basis of employment. Untouchability has been eradicated, abolished. All these things are on the paper. And again, I remind, 2 years back when I spoke on the same platform, I told that fascism is creeping in India. That is what I use the word, creeping. Now it is trying to dominate the entire India by infiltrating all. They wanted to change the Indian constitution. That is the fight they are having. So now, what all the differences that we have, we should forget it and all. Anand Tutabe came to Chennai about 2 months back. After such that has made his home, he spoke a wonderful speaking. He made that this is a time that all the forces should unite together and defeat the fascist BJP. Otherwise, after 2019 April, we cannot convene the meeting like this. That is what now we say that Popular Front of India has been banned in Jorgan. Tomorrow after May, we cannot imagine that we can even hold the meeting like this, even inside the hall. In Tamil Nadu, for organizing a meeting inside the hall, we are not permitted. Permission is denied. We need not get a permission from the police for the inside hall meeting. But where immediately we are, if you want to hold a meeting inside the hall, immediately they serve that your permission is denied. Court is also upholding that. So Article 19 only has been now thrown dustbin. So what we have to do? The people, Sangh Parivar people, BJP group, RSS, they did not want India to be free from British Raj. RSS did not want to get free from Nagpur. They have convened a meeting and they told that we don't want any liberated India. But now they are ruling the country. If they allow to again occupy the power, then again the Manudharma will be repeated. That is the thing. History will not repeat, but they try to do it and all. So what we had to do, that is what Ambedkar told, is a graded discrimination, graded class society. And we know very well, class is mobile, but caste is immobile. That is a very distinctive thing that we are seeing here. Kanjileya has spoken about the struggle. I have read in the Communist Manifesto, the first word is the history of class struggle. That's the first word he said. So far the philosophers, interpret the world, but the point is how to change of it. That is a question that Humanist Manifesto asked in general. Finally, it now concludes, we want to eradicate, we want to abolish all forms of discrimination in the society. எல்லா விதமான பாகுபாடுகள் முரண்பாடுகளை ஒழிப்பது தான். We will lose, accept nothing, now change, but we will achieve a great world. That is what he told. How to achieve that world? We are all equal before law. Equality before law. That means, when he said, even K.R. Narayanan or this Govind may become a president of India, but even now he cannot enter into Tirupati temple. That is the point though. So Hinduism means minus casteism, Hinduism is not there. It is not. You can change your party, you can change your religion, but you cannot change the caste. That is a sin of the society. So unless and until this Hinduism as a philosophy, as a religion is abolished, we cannot achieve equality. That is why Ambedkar wanted to go to Buddha. We know very well. And we know that all religions speak equality except Hinduism. And we know very well, the only one point I want to make it here. Godse shot Gandhi. He gave a confession statement before the court that all we know very well. He declared, he said, I read Gita, I shot Gandhi. I read Gita. Gita is a book that was in the hands of Gandhi. Gandhi is a disciple of Rama. He declared about Ramarajya. He was also told about Gita is a very good preaching book and all. But what Godse told in the court, open court, he declared, I read Gita, I shot Gandhi. Gandhi was shot not because of the fact that he fought for the unity of Hindu religion, but also he wanted to eradicate the root of this discrimination. How? When you go to Sabarimala Ashramam, it is a principle there. Anybody who comes there, whether Nehru or whoever it may be, they must work there and then only they can eat there. They must not only to work there. If you just go to a bathroom and if you have anything, it is for the man who has created a creature has to be removed by him. It is not for the separate man. Then we read it and all, we asked, what does it mean? I read Gita, I shot Gandhi. Gita says the caste has been created by God. That is the preaching of the Gita. Gita says and declares, caste is not a creation of human being. It is a creation of God. That is Gita says. That is why this Gandhiji wanted to eradicate this casteism fundamentally. That's why we shot him. So it's very, very dangerous thing. If the BJP Sangh Paribar group is allowed to come back, then again we have to go back for the another 200 years back and on. Therefore, we must distinguish the enemy first of all. Who is the main enemy? Hindu, I want to finish with only one sentence here. Fascist, we have read in the history, fascist Hitler cleans the one community, one Yudhas and all. But here, what we see, Sangh Paribar group, Hinduism, so-called Hindutva people, Sangh Paribar people is coming with crony capitalism, crony corporate capitalism. So the crony capitalist corporate as well as with Sangh Paribar group have to be thrown out for the power by the unification of the masses, that is the underprivileged, oppressed people, that is the Dalits, Adivasis, women, workers, and minorities. These are all the peoples who have been suppressed, for whom only we are fighting. Therefore, fittingly, rightly, NCHR has awarded VTR, is right person for this thing. On behalf of the Tamil Nadu chapter, I really thank this NCHR's national office parents for giving me an opportunity and to hear a diversified, very, what a great think tanks that we have got it and all here. We appreciate it. I also appreciate Kalichilvi here, because there is no time for me to compare so many things with the Periyar, Marx, and the Ambedkar, these three scholars. When I went to UK last time, I got to the great museum that you might know, it's the greatest museum in the world. where I have found two names. Those who have read all the books of the museum those times, those names are, one is Karl Marx, you know, another one is Ambedkar. These only two persons have read all the books in this there. But Periyar, a man who has studied only third standard, has talked about the equality, liberation of women, and all these things are there. Therefore, unifying all these things, NCHRO is now upholding the human right culture. Therefore, I thank the NCHRO for having given me this opportunity and allow me to have this here.